jumped it well. Bar the Shouting, two lengths to Belly and Gamble is under the whip and they're well clear of Direct Mile. Bar the Shouting tackled by Belly and Gamble on the inside. Bar the Shouting is drifting out on the track. Belly and Gamble is getting to him on the inside. Bar the Shouting and Belly and Gamble. Here's a great go to the line with 100 metres left to go. Bar the Shouting on the outside. Belly and Gamble. Bar the Shouting just the leader. Bar the Shouting in front. And Bar the Shouting has won the dominant Grand National Steeplechase.
Bar the Shouting, ridden by Tim Wheeler, started at 11-2 from Valley and Gamble at 8s, and Direct Mail also at 11-2. Noble Heritage was Unplay's favourite at 13-8. In the $75,000 Winter Championship final, English Charm shared favouritism, and he made it after a great finishing burst.
In the centre, Young Vigilante, followed by New Bell, and English Charm from a long way back is starting to flash home. Duke of Oak Hill has taken the lead. English Charm is flying on the outside. English Charm coming after Duke of Oak Hill. English Charm on the outside is doing best. A big run. English Charm has won it from Duke of Oak Hill.
English Charm with Greg Hall in the saddle started 9-2 equal favourite from Duke of Oak Hill at 8s and Bravado at 40-1. Novell was Unplaced equal favourite at 9-2. In the second leg at the Daily Double, the Foster's Lawn Handicap, Sungai Wang was the popular pick. Here's John Russell again.
250 metres left to go. Romantic Game on the outside is the leader. Sungai Wang is coming at it on the inside with a very strong run. Sungai Wang has taken the lead with 100 metres to go from Romantic Game. New Orange and finishing fast, worth a mention. But it's Sungai Wang for the money and Sungai Wang wins nicely. Sungai Wang has won. Now there's a photo for the minor placings.
Sungai Wang, ridden by Ernie Marchant, started 7-2 favourite from worth a mention at 100-1 and Broquillo at 6s.
Ah-ha-ooh.